गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचिंग सोशल स्टडीज ऑफ 9th स्टैंडर्ड. सो टुडे लेट मी स्टार्ट द लेसन इन ज्योग्राफी. ओपन पेज नंबर 92. फिजियोग्राफिक डिविजन्स ऑफ कर्नाटक. फिजियोग्राफिक मीन्स हाउ वी कैन डिवाइड द कर्नाटका फिजिकली. ओके, सो Karnataka is a part of peninsular India, means it is a part of India. See, it is in the south of India, isn't it? So which is the capital of Karnataka? Bangalore. Very good. So today let us try to know about the physical divisions, physical features of this state. Okay, now most of the northern part is a plain area, but on the other hand southern south part of it is not plain. It is undulating topography, means there we are able to see ups and downs. Okay, here there are many valleys, gorges, okay, rivers, and most of the areas of the state is 450 to 900 meters above sea level. See, above sea level it is there because after Western Ghats, okay, we are able to see the plateau here, and some areas are more than 1800 meters above. Okay, so on the basis of structure and relief, Karnataka can be divided into three important physical divisions. Okay, Karnataka is one of the most prosperous state. Okay, it is very lucky to have good climate here. Okay, we are able to see lot of rivers okay flowing here, both in coastal areas and even in the maidan, north maidan areas, or in south maidan. Okay, here physically we can divide Karnataka into three: the coastal plain, the Malnad region, and maidan region. See here this is Karnataka. If suppose this is, then see there, to the west of Karnataka coastal region is there. Coastal means it is a place very near to the seaside, and after that Malnad region comes. Here we are able to see Sahyadri mountains or Western Ghats are moving. Then this is northern mountain. You are all staying in northern mountain, and this is southern maidan. Okay, this way means Karnataka can be, we can divide Karnataka into three parts: coastal plain, Malnad, and northern maidan. First, now let us try to know about the coastal region in detail. See, as a result of reorganization of states on linguistic basis, Karnataka acquired sea coast and coastal plains as part of the territories. Here, actually the North Kannada district, means Karwar district, was actually with the Bombay province, and this Mangalore, today's Udupi and Bangalore, were with Madras presidency. Then automatically those in those areas most of the people were speaking Kannada, therefore it merged within Karnataka. So three districts comes in coastal plain areas. So which are they? In north we are able to see North Karnataka, Kannada district, or North Kannada district, Uttara Kannada district, and in middle there comes Udupi district, then Mangalore district. Okay, these three districts comes here. The coastline extends to 320 kilometers from Mangalore in the south to Karwar in the north. See here, see, this is Mangalore below, and here it to the north of it is Karwar. Okay, till there means nearly 320 kilometers it is extending okay. Its width varies from 12 to 64 kilometers. Its width is in some places 12 kilometers. It is very narrow. See there in some places it is very wide in some places. Okay, so it is broad in the south and becoming narrow toward the north. Okay, it is very broad. See here, Mangalore side it is very broad, and if you move toward the north, it is becoming very narrow and narrow. And okay, its height is more than 200 meters above sea level. It is called the Kenara or Karnataka coastline. The total coastline of Karnataka is called Kenara coastline or Karnataka coastline. Okay, many fast flowing rivers cut through these coastal areas, is formed by sea erosion. See here, many fast flowing rivers are moving here, like Kali in Karwar, okay, then Gangavadi, okay, the Aganashini, so many, okay, which rivers flows in Dharmasthala? Okay, can you tell? Okay. Netravati is flowing in Dharmasthala. So many small rivers are flowing, starting from Western Ghats, moving towards Arabian Sea to join. Okay, so the rivers have estuaries, but they don't have deltas. Okay, they directly joins with the sea without forming any deltas here. Okay, you will come to know what is delta afterward. There are many ports along the coastline. Okay, here there are many important ports. Among the New Mangalore is the major port in Karnataka. See here. Here there is a New Mangalore port in the south of south coastline. It is the major port. Then other ports are Bhatkala, Malpe, Karwar, Kumta, Belekere and Honnavar. They are fishing ports. See here. Fish is mainly available from the sea and even from the rivers. Okay, fishing, we are able to see all these ports. Bhatkala, Malpe, Karwar, Kumta, Honnavar are fishing ports. If you really like to eat the fresh fish, you better come to these districts. Okay, many beautiful beaches are formed along the sea coast. Attract tourists. Here there are beautiful beaches are there. Beaches means it is like the extended sand areas near the seaside. Okay, and people can stay there, they can stand there and they can watch the beauty of the sea. Okay, for example, see here, many beautiful places attract tourists here. Some of the prominent beaches are Panambur, it is Ullal and Someshwar beaches near Mangalore. See here, these are the beaches near Mangalore, Panambur, Ullal and Malpe near Udupi. Karwar in the north, okay, are some of the important beaches, and Murdeshwar near Honnavar. Marwante and Om beach near Gokarn are some of the important beaches. Especially Om beach attracts the foreign tourists. Okay, then because the shape of the beach itself is in the Om form. Okay, the Hindu symbol Om form. Therefore, it attracts the foreign tourists also. There are small islands located near the sea coast. Okay, there are some islands also there. For example, Saint Mary's Coast, Saint Mary's Island. It is a coconut island near Malpe. Okay, but there is a facility of boat. If you want to move there and you can stay one day there and you can enjoy yourself. Then Anja Dweep near Karwar and Devgarh also very near. Okay. Then Kanji Gudda Islands are notable. See here, there are, if you move towards Karwar especially, you are able to see a lot of islands are located in the Arabian Sea. The main occupation of the people here is fishing along with agriculture. Agriculture also one of the most important profession here. Here mainly paddy is grown, and fish and paddy are the main ingredients food of the people of coastal line. Crops like cashew, coconut, arecanut, cardamom, paddy are grown here. Along with paddy, they grow there. We are able to see coconut, arecanut, okay, adike, cardamom, elaki, paddy grown here. Dakshina Kannada, Udupi and Uttara Kannada are the districts comes here. So let me, here there is some general knowledge. The New Mangalore port is called the gateway of Karnataka. Here Mumbai is called the gateway of India, isn't it? Like that, if you can enter, if suppose anybody wants to enter from the seaside, Arabian seaside, then Mangalore is the best place. Okay, this is a port, important port. Foreigners, if suppose they are coming by sea, they enter through it, through this port to Karnataka. Therefore, it is called the gateway of Karnataka. Then Saint Mary's island is referred locally as Tonsepar. See, Tonsepar is a local name of that Saint Mary's island. Then there is a Netrani islands near Murdeshwar, and it has plenty of pigeon. Okay, and it is known as the pigeon island. Okay, if you move towards Murdeshwar, there is a Netrani island. Lot of pigeons you can see. Okay. If you love nature, you better visit that place. Okay, so this is about coastal Karnataka. Okay, coastal plain of Karnataka. Students, let me ask you one question. Which are the districts comes in coastal Karnataka? Three main districts. Uttara Kannada or Karwar is the main place, district place of it. Then comes Udupi district, then comes Dakshina Kannada district. So the coastline of Karnataka is called as what? Kanara coast or Karnataka coast. Okay, so how the name Kanara came? Actually, the British were unable to pronounce the word Kannada. Okay, instead of that, they told Kanara. That therefore we retain that mispronunciation, I think, and therefore the in English we call it as a Kanara coast. Okay, so now let me move towards another important region, that is Malnadu region. Okay, so Malnadu region comes in between coastal line, coastal plain, and Northern Maidan and Southern Maidan. It is in between it. Okay, it is called as Malnadu. Malay means the hill. Okay, the land of hills. Malnadu means the word Malnadu means the land of hills. The Western Ghats in our state is referred as Malnadu or the land of hills. Okay, so see here, the coastline from north to south. See here, Malnadu runs parallel to the coastline from north to south. See here, we are able to see it is running from north to south. Okay, they have steep terrace like slopes in the west and gentle slopes in the east. Here we are able to see lot of mountains are here. Okay, western side it is steep slopes it got, but on the other side it is very gentle. Okay, you can very easily in the eastern side, and they are called ghats. They are 650 kilometers in length and 50 to 76 kilometers in width. See here, this Malnadu area in Karnataka is having 650 kilometers length and 50 to 76 kilometers in width. Okay, so and the height ranges from 900 to 1500 meters from sea level. See, see here, it is too much above from the sea level. Okay, these hills obstruct the rain bearing winds from the Arabian Sea. Okay, this is especially obstructs rain bearing winds, especially which is coming from the Arabian Sea during the rainy season and causes heavy rains. Okay, more than 200 centimeters of rainfall occurs here, and even there is heavy rainfall in coastal area. Okay, therefore, where there is more rain, it is very helpful for the cultivation of paddy. Okay, then the highest peaks in this region, okay, like are Mullayanagiri, Kudremukha, Kalatagiri, Rudragiri, Devarana Magudda. Here there are so many big peaks are here. These are the names. All these peaks are in Chikmagalur district. Okay, it is Chikmagalur, not Chikmagalur. Many of you mispronounce it. Chikmagalur, it is not Chikmagalur. Mangalur, it is Chikmagalur district. It is a very beautiful district. Okay, if you really loves nature, you better visit Chikmagalur district. Beside these, the other peaks of Malnad region are this Ballarayana Durga, Marti Gudda, Pushpagiri, Kodachadri. Among these, Mullayanagiri heights around 1913 meters. It is the highest peak in the state. Okay, so Mullayanagiri is the highest peak. Okay, so the routes from the eastern plains of Karnataka to the coastal plains across the western ghats are called mountain passes. Here there are so many roads that which are connecting Malnad area with the coastal areas. They are called as mountain passes. Okay, the important passes here are Charmadi Ghat. Okay, it links between Mangalore and Chikmagalur. Okay, then Shiradi Ghat, it links Hassan, Sakleshpur and Mangalore. Agumbe Ghat, it links Shivamogga and Udupi. So perhaps Agumbe Ghat is so terrible, okay, that only minibuses pass there. Okay, so I hope you better, at least in one lifetime, you have to move through minibus. That itself is a great adventure. Okay, so one feels very frightened to move through minibus, okay, in that Agumbe Ghat. So I suggest you should be adventurous in life. So if you want to become adventurous, you try to move across that road. Then Hulikal Ghat, it links Shivamogga and Kundapur. Okay, I think this is enough. Remaining things related to Malnadu, I will tell you in the next video. This is enough. So which are the three important, how we can divide Karnataka into three regions physically? Coastal plain, then Malnadu region, then Maidan Pradesh. Of Maidan Pradesh consists of Northern Maidan and Southern Maidan. I hope you understood this. And which is the highest peak in Karnataka? Mullayanagiri. What is the height of it? 1913 kilometer. Read this and good day, and try to prepare question answers related to this topic. Thank you. Good day.